Hello YouTube and welcome to another route learning video. In today's video I wanted to do something a little bit different before I move on to covering the West Coast Mainline North route. So I've decided to cover the Woodhead line from Manchester London Road to Sheffield Victoria. The scenario is called 2 Lincoln Central and it comes with the route, and our traction for the journey today will be a Class 76 locomotive. We'll be calling at Guide Bridge, Dinting, Hadfield, Penistone and finally Sheffield, although with the scenario we will also be making a brief unscheduled stop at Crowden. The total distance for the journey is just under 41.5 miles. The Woodhead line is now closed in real life, so this route is modelled as it was in the 1950s, and in fact Manchester London Road Station is what is known today as Manchester Piccadilly Station. So the locomotive, the Class 76, is also known as the EM1, which means Electric Mixed Traffic. It runs on the 1500 volt DC overhead system, which was specially designed for the Woodhead line and is non-standard to electrified lines in the UK today, which all use the 25 kilovolts AC overhead system. The maximum speed of the locomotive is 65 miles per hour with a power output of 1300 horsepower. The prototype Class 76 locomotive was built in 1941, and a total of 58 of these locomotives were constructed between 1950 and 1953, specifically for use on the Woodhead line, for use with both passenger and freight trains due to the nature of the steep gradients along this route. In fact, on our journey today we will be climbing almost all of the way to the halfway point, which is roughly Woodhead Tunnel, and then from there we will be descending pretty much all of the way to Sheffield. Once in the cab of the Class 76, the first thing that we need to do is change the pantograph select switch. Now this has different positions depending on whether you'd like to put up the forward pantograph, the rear pantograph or both. However, I normally put up both pantographs, so we turn that to the up position, which is just slightly to the right, and now if I press P, the pantograph will go up. And now you can see that the two red lights have come on above the pantograph selector switch, and you also heard the pantograph connect to the overhead wires, and now you can hear that we have power in the loco. The next thing that I now need to do is move the reversing handle into the forward position, which you've just seen move now. The lever above the reversing handle is the regenerative brake handle. The regenerative brake system on the Class 76 loco is fairly complicated, so we'll be going through how to use that further up in the scenario. And now here we have the traction mode lever. So there are two traction modes on this locomotive, series and parallel. Series is the lower setting, and so what we would do is we would increase the throttle, which is the next lever above that, in series mode, and then when we're doing around 30 miles per hour we'll have to shut off the power and then change the mode from series to parallel. At this point we will then be able to accelerate to speeds above 30 miles per hour. Over to the left of the cab, the top switch that you can see is the weight transfer switch. This is used on very heavy freight trains to increase the tractive effort of the locomotive temporarily, and it's effective up to around 20 miles per hour. We won't need to use this switch today as we're on a passenger train. And then on the lever below that we have the locomotive brake. In front of us now we have a series of gauges which all do mean something in this locomotive. So at the top we have what I'll call the four white gauges, or for the purposes of this video I'll just call them the four gauges. So from left to right, the one on the left is the line volt meter, and this indicates the voltage that the train is receiving from the overhead wires. The next one to the right is the motor volt meter, and that is used for the regenerative or dynamic brake system, and so you'll see that in use later on in the journey. The next one to the right of that is the field ammeter, which shows the current usage of the motors. And finally, the white gauge to The furthest right is the armature ammeter, which shows the current generation and consumption when the regenerative braking is being used. The other important gauges that we need to look at are down here. And so on the left we have the vacuum brake pressure. The lower the two needles are pointing, the harder the brakes are applied. So now I've just moved the brake handle, you can see that the needles have dropped, indicating that the brakes are now applied in a harder position. In the middle we have the speedometer, and on the bottom right we have the brake cylinder pressure gauge. From left to right on the bottom three lights, the left light, which says line, which is currently illuminated blue, indicates that we're connected to the overhead electric system and that we are receiving power. The middle light, the green one, which says transfer, will become active if we hit the weight transfer switch. And the light on the right, resistance, that usually lights up when we've got too much power in the motors. So if we were to accelerate too quickly or apply too much power, then the ammeter, the amps gauge, which is the second from the right of the four white gauges, that would be quite high, above 800, getting close to 1000. At that point normally the red light would illuminate and we'd have to reduce the power. However, at higher speeds, for some reason, the red light comes on, even though the amps are fairly low, which I do think is a slight bug with this locomotive. One final thing which I need to do before we depart is to turn on the instrument lights by clicking the instrument light switch, and then to set up the headlights correctly. So because we're an express passenger train, we need the two bottom outer lights illuminated, which is marker light number 2 and marker light number 4. Departing from Manchester London Road, the starting speed limit is 15 miles per hour, and we've got around 5 miles to go to the next stop, which is Guide Bridge. Now that we've reached 15 miles per hour, I've just idled the power until we're able to accelerate further. There is a 30 mile per hour speed limit coming up very shortly. We are now entering the 30 mile per hour speed zone, and we are able to accelerate once we've passed the semaphore signals just coming up. See that as I'm increasing power that the ammeter, which is the second from the right of the four white gauges, is climbing. And in fact you might have noticed that the red light just came on at the bottom of the cab, indicating that I'd applied too much power. So I've just gone down one step to ensure that the red light doesn't come on and I'm not overloading the train. Now that we've reached 30 miles per hour, I cut the power to idle and then I've moved it up one notch, just to try and ensure that we don't lose too much speed. We're now passing through Ardwick Station. The speed limit here is now going up to 50 miles per hour, so I'm just going to idle the power and now press the B key to change to the parallel power mode. As you've just seen, the handle just moved forward there. And we can accelerate at this overhead gantry just here, just before the signal. Now passing through Ashbury's station. As we've now reached 50 miles per hour, I'm going to reduce the power to try and ensure that we don't break the speed limit. The speed limit will shortly be going up to 75 miles per hour, though we do have to bear in mind that the maximum speed of this loco is 65, so I'm going to try and not exceed 65 today. Speed limit is now going up to 75 miles per hour, and we can accelerate towards that as we pass the signal that we've just passed. And the station that we're now approaching is Gorton. At this point I have applied power and the red light has come on. However, looking at the ammeter, I'm not sure that the red light should be on. Therefore, I'm not going to reduce power at this point. Now approaching Fairfield station. Once we've passed through the station, we will have just 1.25 miles to go to our stop at Guide Bridge. So at this point now, I'm going to idle the power, and I'm very shortly going to set up the dynamic braking system so that you can see it in action slowing down. There is a 35 mile per hour speed limit just before Guide Bridge station. So now I've idled the power, I'm going to press the full stop key to move the dynamic brake handle. You can now see the second gauge from the left of the four white gauges. The needle is climbing. I have to keep pressing full stop until it is at the same level as the gauge directly to the left of it, the line voltmeter. Now I have to apply the power handle up to the full setting. And now if I press the full stop key, it will apply the dynamic braking and bring our speed down. And indeed, you can see in the very right hand of the four white gauges that that needle has fallen. So I've applied full dynamic braking to slow us down for the 35 mile per hour speed limit coming up. As we get to 35, I will then reduce the dynamic braking, but you do have to be careful because you can move the dynamic brake handle in the opposite direction, causing the train to accelerate. If that happens, then you will see the needle on the second gauge from the left start to go down rather than up. You can now see Guide Bridge Station just coming up, so I'm once again applying the dynamic brake. As we get to lower speeds, the dynamic brake becomes less and less effective, so I'm now applying the air brakes to slow us down more. The brakes on this train are not particularly good, and so I try to enter platforms at no faster than around 20 miles per hour. We do need to stop just before the signal at the end of the platform here, and I'm applying the air brakes to a harder setting now to bring our speed off and try and stop in the right place. Now that it's time to depart from Guide Bridge, I need to move the power handle to the off position and completely turn off the dynamic braking. I also need to shift the power mode back to the series position. And at this point, I'm going to apply a couple of notches of power and release the brakes. I always try to apply power just before we start moving, in case we start on an uphill gradient, to prevent the train from rolling back. The starting speed limit here at Guide Bridge is 35 miles per hour, and we've got just under 7 miles to go to the next stop, which is Dinting. As we're now approaching 30 miles per hour, I'm going to idle the power, and now I'm going to change the power mode to the parallel mode, and now I'm going to reapply power to bring our speed up. The speed limit will shortly be going up to 75 miles per hour at this speed board just here. However, we're only about a mile away from the next speed limit, which is a reduction back down to 50 miles per hour. So as we get to 50, we won't accelerate above that. We are currently going uphill quite steeply on a gradient between 1 in 100 and 1 in 86. Sorry, I had to try and remember that for a second there. Speed limit is now going back up to 75 miles per hour, however only 1¾ miles from the next speed reduction, which is back down to 50 miles per hour. We are currently on a 1 in 86 uphill gradient, which is severely affecting our ability to accelerate. Passing through Newton Station, which is 1 mile from the 50 mile per hour speed limit, and so what I'm going to do is idle the power at the next signal coming up. Going to use the air brakes to slow us down to the 50 limit, and I'm going to brake at the rear of the signal on the track to the right just there. Now you can see the vacuum pressure falling, and I'm going to make it so that the needles are pointing to the number 10 on the vacuum pressure gauge on the left, and we're now down to 50 miles per hour. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of power to ensure that we don't lose too much speed. We're now passing through Godley Junction Station. The speed limit is now going back up to 75 miles per hour, and I'm going to power up just at the overhead gantry that we just passed under. Now that we're doing around 65 miles per hour, I've just reduced the power to try and ensure that we don't go above that speed. We're now passing through Broadbottom Station, so we've got just over 1 mile to go to the next speed limit, which is a reduction down to 50 miles per hour. Have a warning for the 50 mile per hour speed limit. So I'm now going to idle the power, and I'm going to brake for the speed limit at the next signal just coming up. Speed limit is now down to 50 miles per hour, and we've just passed through Mottram Holt. The next signal that we go past just coming up is half a mile from the next speed limit, which is a reduction down to 40 miles per hour. So I've just left the power in idle, and I'm allowing the train to coast down towards that speed. We are going uphill slightly still, which will aid in our deceleration. We've now got a warning for the 40 speed limit. I will use the brakes at the last moment if I need to slow us down, but I think that we're going to be travelling slow enough as we enter the 40 limit. At this point, I'm just going to leave the power in idle, as our stop at Dinting is just the other side of this large bridge that we're now crossing. You can see the platform coming up just ahead. So as we get slightly closer to the platform, I'm now going to apply the brakes down to 10 on the vacuum brake gauge. I'm going to go slightly harder than that now, just to try and ensure that we're not too fast entering the platform. One thing that we do need to take note of as we enter the platform is that the signal at the other end is displaying a single yellow aspect. So if that doesn't change by the time we depart, then we will have to drive with caution, assuming that the next signal is a red signal. Now it's time to depart from Dinting. I'm just going to change the power mode back to series, and now I'm going to apply a couple of notches of power and then release the brakes, as we are starting on a 1 in 100 uphill gradient. We certainly don't want the train to roll back. Notice that the signal is still displaying a single yellow aspect, so I will be driving with caution. Departing from Dinting, the starting speed limit is 40 miles per hour, and we've got just over 3/4 of a mile to go to the next stop, which is Hadfield. As you can see, the speed limit is now going up to 70 miles per hour, though we certainly won't be able to achieve that before we get to our next stop. Now that we're doing just over 20 miles per hour, I've idled the power until I can see the next signal coming up, as I want to ensure that I have enough braking power to stop should the signal be displaying a red aspect. You can now see our signal coming up by the looks of it, and it is showing a red aspect, so I'm going to approach the signal with caution. Being on an uphill gradient has helped us to slow down, and as you can just see, the signal has now changed to a single yellow aspect, which means that we are cleared into the station at Hadfield. So I'm now just going to apply a bit of power to bring our speed up, though just around this corner we will be entering the platform. I have now idled the power again as we're entering the platform here. We do need to stop at the other end. I'm going to allow the train to coast down in speed and then use the brakes as necessary as we get closer to the end of the platform. We are still on a 1 in 100 uphill gradient, which will aid with our deceleration here and will also affect our acceleration as we depart from Hadfield. Once again departing from Hadfield, I've added a couple of notches of power before releasing the brakes to ensure that we don't roll back. According to the briefing in the activity, or scenario should I say, there is a broken down train ahead of us, so we will be routed onto the goods line part of our journey up towards Woodhead Tunnel. And so at this point we will be making an unscheduled stop at Crowden Station just for a short moment. The starting speed limit at Hadfield was 70 miles per hour and we've got around 4.5 miles to go to Crowden. We will be on an almost constant 1 in 100 uphill gradient all of the way there. As we're now approaching 30 miles per hour, I'm just going to idle the power and now change into parallel mode before reapplying power to try and ensure that we don't lose too much speed. This should now enable us to accelerate to higher speeds, though as you can see the gradient coupled with the fact that this locomotive just isn't all that powerful is affecting our ability to accelerate. There's another loco available for this route that's a lot like the Class 76 that I'm driving, which is the Class 77, also known as the EM2 loco. It's slightly larger and slightly more powerful. Just to point out that the jerk that you just saw there is unfortunately a bug with this route, and it happens every time I drive over that section of track. So as I was saying, the EM2 loco is also available for Train Simulator, which is a larger and more powerful version of the EM1 which we're currently driving. All of the driving principles are the same, except that there is no weight shift button on the EM2 loco. But one of the issues is that the speedometer has been made completely wrong, unfortunately. And in fact, it appears to be reading in kilometres per hour rather than miles per hour. Because when I'm doing around 60 miles per hour, it says that you're doing around 100 on the speedometer. So unfortunately, it wouldn't really be easy to make a route learning video with that loco, which I actually prefer to this one, just because I wouldn't be able to accurately tell what speed we're travelling at. Another 1950s route, which I am hoping to cover in the not-so-distant future, is the Western Lines of Scotland route, which will have to be covered in a couple of parts, and I'm hoping to cover this in first-generation DMUs, and also possibly a steam loco. So I'm thinking of making my first route learning video on a steam locomotive, which will be the Black 5. At this crossing here with the footbridge, we've got just under 2 miles to go to Crowden. This overbridge here, we've now got 1.25 miles to go to Crowden. We will shortly be seeing a yellow signal, and once we see the yellow signal, I'm going to idle the power and apply the brakes. See the yellow signal coming up just ahead, so I'm idling the power now, and just before we reach the signal I'm going to brake down as far as the number 5 on the vacuum brake gauge. This should bring our speed off about right for the signal just ahead, which I believe is a failed signal, at which we're going to have to request permission to proceed. It appears that our signal has cleared, and so we don't have a failed signal like I thought we had, and it's showing that we will be going over onto the goods line in a moment, which is why we've got the left hand feather indicator illuminated. You can see Crowden station just coming up now, and so I'm going to aim to stop at the end of the platform, which is actually slightly too short for this train if I remember rightly. Now that we're cleared to depart from Crowden, I'm going to change the power mode back once again, and now apply 3 steps of power, and then release the brakes. Departing from Crowden, the starting speed limit is 70 miles per hour, though it's quickly down to 15 as we cross over onto the goods line. We've got just under 11.25 miles to go to the next stop, which is Penistone. have temporarily shut off power as we've reached 15 miles per hour. The speed limit is shortly going up to 50 now that we've crossed onto the goods line. The point at which we can accelerate is when you can see the rocky hill to the left. As the rocky part enters the left-hand window just here, we can now accelerate up towards 50 miles per hour. As we're now approaching 30 miles per hour, I'm just going to shut off the power and change the power mode. And now reapply once again. We will shortly be crossing back from the goods line onto the main line once again. And at that point, the speed limit will once again be dropping back to 15 miles per hour, just at the point we cross over. Now that we're doing just over 40 miles per hour, I'm going to idle the power and allow the train to coast. We should soon see a warning for a reduction down to 15, at which point I'm then going to apply the brakes to slow down. Now got the 15 warning along with a single yellow signal, so I'm now going to apply the brakes and bring our speed down. Now that we've got down to this low speed, I'm just going to change the power mode back once again to series. And as you can see, we're now entering the 15 mile per hour speed zone. Once the rear of the train has cleared these points, the speed limit will be going up to 70 miles per hour. We are now passing through Woodhead station, and we're now free to accelerate up to the 70 mile per hour speed limit. The tunnel just ahead is Woodhead Tunnel, which is the longest tunnel on the line. I'm not certain exactly how long it is, but I'll try and look that up and see if I can include that in a caption in the video. I believe it's 3 to 4 miles long. About halfway through the tunnel, the gradient will level out, and as we come out the other side of the tunnel, we will start going downhill, and we'll be going downhill almost all of the way to Sheffield. While the speed limit is 70 miles per hour here in the tunnel, it will be going down to 50 miles per hour just as we exit at the other end. Once again, we're now approaching 30 miles per hour, so I'm just going to idle the power and change power modes, and then reapply power once again. Gradient will shortly be levelling out, and at that point we'll be getting close to the end of the tunnel. As the gradient levels out, I'm going to idle the power and allow the train to coast. Then shortly after leaving the tunnel, we're going to start setting up the regenerative brake system again. We're going to be using that a lot more for this second half of the journey to try and control our speed on the descent. So the gradient is levelling out here now, so I'm going to idle the power. As you can see, our speed is now coming off towards 50. Going to leave the speed around. Sorry, I'm going to try and hold us at around that speed. We'd just also like to take this opportunity to remind you that you can find me on Facebook to get the latest updates on what's going on with the PTG Rail project. And so you can find me there under PTG Rail. I will post the link to that in the description of this video. Also, if you really do appreciate my work and would like to become a patron of this channel and donate financially on a monthly basis or even a one-off donation, then please do visit my Patreon page, which the link will also be in the description for the video. The speed limit has now dropped to 50 miles per hour, and we're just passing through Dunford Bridge Station. I'm now going to set up the dynamic brake system, so as you can see, the power is already off. I've moved the dynamic brake handle to match the line voltage gauge, and now I'm applying the power handle to the full position. Now I have control of the train speed through the dynamic brake system. So as we are going on a downhill section, I've just applied a little bit of dynamic braking to try and ensure that we don't break the speed limit. see, I'm just making very minor adjustments to the dynamic brake handle to try and control our speed. The speed limit has now gone up to 70 miles per hour. So instead of deactivating the whole dynamic brake system, I'm going to use it to accelerate. As I mentioned earlier, if you move the brake handle in the opposite direction, it will actually act in the opposite way and cause the train to accelerate rather than slow down. This isn't something you should normally make a habit of doing, but just for the purposes of this section, I'm going to use it to bring us up towards 65 miles per hour. Now getting up towards 65 miles per hour, so I'm changing the brake handle once again, and it's now in the off position. If we start to gain speed above 65, I will just use a couple of notches of dynamic braking to control our speed. Crossing we've just crossed on this right hand curve with the signal box there, we were 2/3 of a mile from the next speed limit, which is a reduction in speed down to 50 miles per hour. Going to brake for that just as we passed under the overbridge that we've just passed under there. Once we enter the 50 mile per hour speed zone, we will then be around half a mile from the next speed limit, which is a reduction down to 30 miles per hour. Entering the 50 mile per hour speed zone. I'm going to brake for the 30 mile per hour speed limit as we enter the next right hand curve. And I'm going to use full dynamic brakes and air brakes as well if required. Now entering the 30 mile per hour speed zone, and you can see Penistone station just coming up. So I'm just braking now to try and enter the platform at no faster than 20 miles per hour. And once again, we need to stop at the end of the platform. departing from Penistone. I'm just going to apply a couple of notches of power and now release the brakes. The starting speed limit here at Penistone is 30 miles per hour, and we've got around 13 miles to go to the final stop, which is Sheffield. As we've reached 25 miles per hour, I'm now going to idle the power and allow the train to continue to coast, as we are on a down 1 in 100 gradient. So we are slowly picking up speed towards 30 miles per hour. The speed limit will shortly be going up to 50 miles per hour, and at that point I'm going to shift the power mode and accelerators up towards that speed. I have just temporarily applied the air brakes to try and control our speed better. I'm not setting up the dynamic braking to control our speed at this stage, as we're about to be accelerating. We have now passed the 50 mile per hour speed board, so I'm going to release the brakes, change the power mode, and at this long overhead gantry that we've just passed under, I can now accelerate up towards the 50 limit. Speed limit is now going up to 60 miles per hour. As we reached 55 miles per hour, I idled the power to allow the train to coast. Again, I'm only going to use the air brakes to control speed temporarily, as the speed limit will soon be going up to 70 miles per hour. Speed limit is now 70 miles per hour, so I'm just going to allow the train to continue to coast up towards 65, and as we get there I will then activate the regenerative brake system. We're now approaching Wortley Station. Approaching Deep Car Station. I'm now going to set up the dynamic braking, ready to control our speed as required. So the dynamic brake lever is now in the right place. The power handle is now set to the right position, and so I can now control our speed with the regenerative braking once again. Just applied one notch of dynamic braking just to control our speed, as I felt we were accelerating slightly too much there. As you can see, the needle speedometer is falling very slowly, and as we get down towards 60 I will reduce the dynamic braking once again and allow us to coast gradually back up towards 65. So we are getting towards 60 miles per hour now. So I've just released the dynamic braking. So we'll slowly start accelerating again now. Passing through Wortley Bridge Station. passing through Wadsley Bridge Station. The next overbridge coming up is 3/4 of a mile from the next speed limit, which is a reduction down to 30 miles per hour. We're going to brake for the 30 speed limit, coming up at a point which will be on a right-hand curve coming up shortly. Full dynamic braking, which should slow us down about right. I will also add air brakes if needed to ensure that we bring our speed down to 30 miles per hour in time. As you can see, I have now added the air brakes and I've gone to 10 on the vacuum brake gauge there. Now at this point we're going to release the braking, just apply very light dynamic braking to bring us the rest of the way. Sorry, not light, actually quite heavy, but the effectiveness of the dynamic brake has gone down now because we're at lower speeds. So the speed limit has now gone down to 30 miles per hour. I'm going to have to use the dynamic brake to control our speed on the approach into Sheffield. We will be going downhill most of the way. Just passed through the closed station at Neep's End. Final speed limit will be a reduction to 15 miles per hour shortly before the station at Sheffield Victoria. We will get a warning for that about a third of a mile from the limit itself. I'm going to reduce the dynamic braking as it becomes ineffective at this speed. Looks like we may have slowed down just slightly too early there. So I'm going to completely release the dynamic braking now. And our speed will be controlled purely by the air brakes from this point on. So I have just had to use the air brakes to bring our speed back down as we were a little over 15, and we are now entering the 15 mile per hour speed zone. You can see Sheffield Victoria Station just ahead of us now. One final thing I'm going to do in case I do need to reapply power is change the power mode back to series. Gradient does level entering the station here, and we need to stop just a little bit before the end of the platform. So we're going to stop at the overhead wire gantry that you can see before the end of the platform. see the overhead wire gantry coming up now. It's the next gantry we're going to get to. So I'm aiming to stop just around here. Thank you very much for watching, and I really hope you've enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to check out my Facebook or Patreon links, which will be posted in the description. Again, thanks for watching.